Welcome back to WTF, everyone. I know you tuned in tonight to see the latest episode of Everyone Loves Berkowitz, but you're getting WTF instead. I'm Jim Biggins, alongside my broadcast partner, Mr. Wiggles, and you might be wondering where we were.
Who gives a shit? Why, if we were gone for like 6 fucking months, or however long it's been, why do we gotta come back to this skinny asshole?
Skinny Wolf, Mr. Wiggles, he's leading things off tonight.
Why couldn't he stay in jail?
Well, that leads me very nicely to the point I was going to make. We were actually going to have WrestleMania 2, and then the FBI came in, and things were not good. And they tried to arrest, like, Joe, and we had to smuggle him out of the arena, the trunk of a car. And then we all had to go split our separate ways and lay low for a while, and that's where we've been. We took all of our stuff.
That's where
luckily,
some of you
we stole
been.
More stuff from Vince McMahon.
A good portion of us have been in prison.
Yeah, I got away.
Like
we're
this
taking
asshole.
Extra steps to make sure that that such an incident should not happen again. And we're back tonight with Skinny Wolf.
And Dickie Moe.
Everyone's favorite
human land
whale.
He's still confused. He's still looking for that sound.
I think he might be.
Every time he hears it, he looks a different direction. He doesn't know what the fuck's going on. He doesn't know the fucking directions, up, down, left, right.
The colors, red,
the
blue.
Colors, red, blue. He doesn't know any of that shit.
I don't know. I just know that Dickie Moe is one of the ones that avoided jail time, thankfully.
Oh, yeah. Well, how can you arrest Dickie Moe? You can't arrest him for being an idiot.
No. He hasn't done anything.
He hasn't really done anything.
Skinny Wolf's looking at him like, I don't know.
It's
he's
going to be back
skinny.
In the ring. Yeah, right. You're about to get your ass stuffed up your own ass. Look, even fucking Dickie Moe's like waving him on like, come on, you little bastard. I'm tired
what,
of this
skinny
shit.
Prick?
Look at him. The fucking ref weighs more than he does. Oh, Jesus.
Dickie Moe starts things off with a lariat in the corner. That's pretty much starting and ending things all at once.
Oh, God, now he's going to choke him with a rope?
Oh, thank God. For a minute, I thought he was going to do that big boss man
thing.
Oh,
my God. He did worse.
Yeah, he did. Jumping knee drop.
Oh,
God.
No. Are you trying to kill him?
I think Dickie Moe is...
The man just got a prison. Give him a break.
Man, you know what happened to Skinny Wolf in prison?
That's what I'm saying. Holy shit, he's been pumping iron.
That was impressive.
Extremely impressive. He gets pushed over like he's a bag of potatoes. Oh, no.
Did he piss at Dickie Moe's cornflakes or something?
No, man, I think Dickie Moe's just has all this pent-up aggression because he hasn't been fighting for, like, 6 months or however
long
it's
been. Yeah, I don't know.
How long has it been?
Too long. That's all I know. Oh, Dickie Moe.
Oh, here we go.
Revving up the train.
So we
gonna
splash.
Splatter Skinny Wolf. All right, now, Dickie Moe, cover him.
I think I audibly heard Skinny Wolf shit himself.
You might have. That's a 2 and a...
Oh my God, he wiggled his way out.
Yeah,
he must have slipped out from the shit.
Yeah, some extra lubrication there. And a side rush and leg sweep. Obviously, Dickie Moe's still stunned that Skinny Wolf actually kicked out.
Oh, he just kicked
there.
It right in the face. When does Skinny Wolf get so aggressive?
I don't know. When did Dickie Moe get so aggressive?
I think everybody's aggressive. They're just all pissed off, full of piss and vinegar, because they haven't been getting paid for 6 months.
At least not for us.
How long have we been going? Because they haven't been paid for that whole long.
It's a 2 and a 3. Skinny Wolf is out of here.
Good. Fuck him. I mean, they've been getting checks, but those checks ain't been cashed.
There's a replay of the tit mash. Skinny Wolf collapsing to the canvas like a... Fought out
like
hot
the
dog.
Like the fucking empty burlap sack full of turds that he is.
There he is kicking out. I don't know how, but I also don't know why. I just could set him up for this.
Oh no.
Yeah. You know, people might say, I can't believe Skinny Wolf actually lost to a body slam, but it's like if you've ever been body slammed by Dickie Moe, then you can talk.
I don't care, that motherfucker could lose to the wind.
That's true. Dickie Moe victorious in our opening bout here tonight on the return of WTF. Skinny Wolf
him.
In
Roll
serious
like
pain.
A fucking... Good. He can get a new fucking gimmick. Grow his hair out or some shit.
You mean like become the skinny werewolf?
Yeah, I kind of like that idea. Maybe we should pitch that to him.
Maybe we should. Here comes another one of your favorites.
Oh my God.
Speaking of werewolves...
Where has this guy been? I bet you he's been near a pool in Miami.
Yeah. from, you know, your local public pool.
Jesus Christ. I still don't get the music.
I don't look at me, man. I didn't pick it.
That shirt probably cost him like $12.99 down at a fucking Goodwill.
And that hat. You know, that like cross is solid gold. That's got to be most of his assets. Personal assets.
Because he's wearing flip-flops, for fuck's sake.
I know.
It looks like the rest of his outfit he picked up like 30 years ago at a fucking Kmart. His arms are so extraordinarily short.
Yeah, I know. His neck. Look at his neck.
I tried not to look at his neck. I like it when he has the shirt on because you can't really, you don't notice the neck as much. What the fuck is this now?
The debut for WTF tonight, folks.
Who's this fucking crazy asshole? Looks like Billy Graham is a lumberjack.
Yes, that's Jack Lombard.
Jack,
he's from Montreal, Quebec, Canada.
Jack Lombard.
Jack Lombard.
So, what was
I didn't come up with this.
What will his name be in the phone book again?
Lombard Jack.
Yes! I hope and a fucking tree falls on this guy.
You know, from the way he's walking down the ring, I think he may have had a few trees fall on him already because he doesn't look entirely
not
stable.
Not the kind I'm thinking of. I'm thinking redwood.
I mean, he doesn't look like he's all there mentally, you know.
That chainsaw didn't even have a chain on it.
You think we let him out there with a chain on it?
We couldn't stop Bill. He got one in here with a fucking chain on it.
Yeah, but Bill will kill somebody. I don't. Well, this motherfucker might too. For all
yeah, look at him. He looks like fucking Macho Man Randy Savage in a flannel.
You know, I wonder if he thinks Pencil Neck Greek is like a ooh,
a yeti?
One-handed backbreaker. See, he's Jack Lombard. He attacks the back.
Oh Jesus Christ!
I wonder if he thinks Pencil Neck Greek is like a bear or something.
I don't know what the fuck he thinks. I mean, I can't imagine what this guy talks like.
Well,
he sounds. Like he's got a mouthful of seaweed anyway.
He kind of sounds like a combination of the McKenzie brothers and Popeye. Ow, well, his pencil like Greek with a headbutt.
Jesus Christ. He says so he sounds like one of the Kipper kids.
Well, no. You can't understand them.
And the last time I checked, you can't really understand Popeye that well either.
There's a big chop, and what's this going to be now? Boston Crab coming up. Oh, giant swing!
Giant swing!
I love a good giant swing. I don't know about you, Mr. Wiggles.
Giant swings are they're underutilized.
I'd like to take a moment to point out that Pencil Neck Greek wrestles in his flip-flops.
And he's got a Greek flag on his ass, too.
Well, that makes sense. The flip-flops thing...
No, it doesn't make really sense. Know. I mean, the Greek flag might make sense, but putting it on his ass? No, it doesn't make sense.
This is a big motherfucker. You notice that? This dude's 6'7", 6'8"?
Yeah, he's gigantic. He looks like Paul Bunyan.
He does look like Paul. Well, I mean, he is Jack Lombard. So, it makes sense. We got a giant swing coming up. Depends on that Greek getting thrown around the ring like a sack of shit.
He is a sack of shit.
So, it's oddly appropriate. Greek with a side headlock going to the eyes. Well, you gotta try something. Nice headbutt again.
Oh, dude. It sounds like two coconuts hitting together like...
Yeah, we don't know what's under that ski cap.
Probably
you have
a metal
plate under there for all we know.
It's either that or like a styrofoam container. Dead sand.
He's not dangerous, Dan. There, the reversal, Jack Lombard, the reversal. Oh, Canadian backbreaker possibly coming up. Ooh!
Oh!
And that's it. That's the Lombard Jack.
Oh, Jesus Christ in heaven.
I think it's all going to be over. One, two, three, yes. Pencil Neck Greek goes down to the Lombard Jack, as performed by Jack Lombard.
The fuck am I looking at?
Professional wrestling at its finest, I guess.
Or its lowest.
No, its lowest is on USA. Oh,
touché.
Did I say that? I didn't
touché.
Mean that.
I don't know, where's TNA broadcasting these days? Are they
some
broadcasting?
Some public access channel.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to say. They're broadcasting on the back of Dickie Moe.
Yeah. Jack Lombard successful in his debut here. Another crazy Canadian asshole running around with a chainsaw. Just what WTF needed.
Do we know he's Canadian? He could be from, like, Washington State or something.
He says he's Canadian. That's all
Speaking
I know.
Speaking of this fucking idiot. Oh, God.
Look at these two motherfuckers.
Oh, he hasn't fixed his lips in all these years?
This week's jobbers on their way to the ring, folks. Skinny Wolf could be a part of it this week.
Oh, was... God. It's been 4 months to college and hasn't worn off yet?
I don't think that's collagen. More? I think it's caulk.
What the fucking $2.99 Home Depot special lips? Lip? Oh, Jesus, fuck.
Right. Here's an interesting question for you, Mr. Wiggles. Which one of these two is uglier?
I don't know. I don't want to look at him anymore. Like, oh, good. I won't have to look at him anymore. They're dead. Thank God.
They may very well not make it out of the arena tonight, folks.
I've got to make sure they don't if they don't fucking get up. I'll roll a grenade in the ring.
I know WTF fans have seen these two beating the piss out of each other on many occasions. They haven't seen them work as a team yet, as far as I can remember.
By the way, but, they were beating the piss out of each other in jail for 4 months, too, I might
yeah.
add.
Yeah. These two are actually really good friends in real life. You might not think by watching them in the ring against each other, but...
Well, they're about to kill the... God, don't show dangerous, Dan, man. We should... Can we censor his face?
You mean, like, put a mosaic over
it? Yeah, put a mosaic over his face. I mean, shit, the I'll children watching this,
I'll pass that suggestion
this,
along and... Uh-oh!
Oh, my God, he's fucking Dan's dead already. I mean, there are kids watching this. I mean, I wouldn't let my kids play Silent Hill. Why the hell are we going to let them watch Dangerous Dan in the ring?
Dangerous Dan, this is already over. Oh, no. Every hit of that sounds like somebody punching a 2-liter bottle.
A 2-liter bottle of horse piss.
Probably some.
Oh, God. My God. He just caved in his forehead.
Yeah. It kicked half his mustache off. I saw it fly out of the ring.
Oh, it's still attached. It's just bent. We had a pipe cleaners anyway.
Oh, okay, geez, this isn't a wrestling match. This is a suplex exhibition. It's like Bo's going down the list. Okay, which ones haven't I done yet?
Haven't done this one again.
You know, Dan's already done here. The only thing that's going to save him is his partner.
His partner almost didn't save him. That's amazing.
Yeah, if Lips Manless had any mercy at all in his soul, he would have let that pinfall go.
Oh, my God. I can't believe Bo just sold that. What the hell are you selling that move for?
He just got punched and didn't sell it.
Oh,
here comes
no.
The T-Bone. Oh, God. T-Bone suplex.
Tag your partner in so we can get him out of here so he stopped losing fucking ratings.
Okay, here comes Lips Manless. Oh, he
oh,
made
jeez. Oh, now he's Lipsless Manless. He's manless, oh, for sure. Oh, jeez.
Spinning heel kick right in the jaw.
He spit out his dentures.
There's Lips Manless. What with a body? Oh, a body slam. That's good. Yeah, that's going to even the odds.
Him in his $2 shirt.
You might be giving him credit with that
oh.
one.
Oh, I can't believe he actually did a move.
Yeah, I don't think Bo can believe it either. There's Bo with a wrestling move. That's unusual.
That's the same wrestling move, ironically.
Yeah. There goes Dangerous Dan to repay the favor. If you're going to let me get my ass kicked, I'm going to make you get your ass kicked.
Oh, no. He just kicked him in his face again. He should have just made of plaster or something. It's going to cave in, like, just
there's
a
Northern
zero.
Light suplex from Bo. There's Dangerous Dan breaking it up.
He came dangerously close to hitting Bo in the nuts, and that's always a recipe for disaster.
Yes, it is.
That.
You should avoid doing that. There's another T-Bone suplex.
Dave just hit
Dave's
him.
Running over.
Hit
looks
him,
like
Dave, damn it.
He's talking shit to Dangerous Dan.
Yeah,
Dan waited until Dave left the ring to get in.
If he had hit him, we'd be mercifully done with this match.
Here's a triple curve on Lips Manless.
Oh, there we go. I will
Dan
the bet
just bounced off the guardrail, folks. And
Urban Champion is going to sue Dangerous Dan when this is over because he caused him to have 7 shattered vertebrae.
I don't see Dan. I think he's embedded in the guardrail over there.
It probably is. His neck stuck between him again.
And Bo's pulling up.
There he is.
There's an exploder. There's Bo pulling up Lips Manless after the triple German just to use another suplex on him. Well, Dan got dislodged from the guardrail at least. That's good.
Yeah, he got up somehow.
There's Bo going for his version of the Kata Hajime.
He's just choking him to death.
Dan's trying to tell him, no, don't tap him. Lips is, Lips is tapping, folks.
Well, his eyes rolled back in his head and his face was fucking blue. He didn't have a choice.
We didn't even see Dave in the ring. Jesus.
His face is making that fish shit like the girl from Airplane.
And next thing you know, he's going to spit out an egg. And here he is getting the triple German again and Dan getting speared into the guardrail.
Dan just fucking Dan.
Yeah, it's a good thing Dan can dislocate his limbs so easily or else he'd be caught in those guardrails a lot.
But he gets caught in them anyway. I mean, people like to shove him through them.
Look at Dan. He's kicking his own partner. Did you see that?
He's an asshole. Have you ever talked to this guy?
I try not to.
Nobody ever tries and wants to, but sometimes you get stuck in the elevator with him.
Well, folks, Bo and Dave successfully. I guess it's just Bo. That really wasn't a wrestling match. More of a suplex demonstration.
Yeah, Dave, this is Dave's night off. He just sat out there drinking a beer.
Yeah, I don't think Dave's going to be, well, oh, Jesus.
God.
I don't think Dave's going to be happy with the fact that he got no action in the night.
Probably not. Maybe they'll go backstage and beat the fuck out of somebody. You had 4 months to lose some weight, Tubbs.
Yeah, he just gained.
Oh my God,
he's
5 pounds
fatter. Heavier.
Jesus Christ, who let this guy near the fucking hot dog cart?
Well, you good luck keeping him away from. Oh, man.
Oh, I didn't miss that.
I didn't either.
Christ in a taxi.
What
did I do
to this?
Oh,
you God.
Ass. Look at this fat fucking rolling. Looks like a sausage off the bun. Get in the ring, Tubbs.
Why didn't somebody tell him to get his hair cut, too? Because
that's why he's telling him to lose some fucking weight.
Well, I'm sure he's been told that.
I
just ain't listening.
Like to think, like to tell this guy. Number one, your hair looks like shit. Number one, you're clumsy as fuck. Two, you're fatter than all fucking hell. Three, four, what number am I on? I don't even know.
I completely lost
he's
track.
He's so fat, he's eating all the numbers.
And here comes Cowboy
don't
Matt.
Play the, don't play the Cowboy Matt music. It's going to make him hungry.
I think he's always hungry.
Yeah, but it's going to make him more hungry. He's going to start sucking in fucking smaller fans out of the front row.
Cowboy Matt on his way to the ring. He's got a feud going with Lardass right
well,
now over that briefcase.
I don't know if he still even cares. I mean, Lardass is definitely eating the briefcase by now.
Well, Lardass actually, he had a, you know, put a picture of himself on Instagram carrying the briefcase. So he's just, he's been taunting Cowboy Matt with it.
You tell me this dumb fat fuck can't even open that thing?
Well, I don't know if he has or hasn't.
He hasn't thought to, like, uh-oh. Looks like somebody hasn't gotten enough beat the shit out of people. Christ,
yeah,
he's still
exactly.
Pumping iron.
Here comes the Pennsylvania Psycho, folks. Ned Ryerson. Scheduled to face Lick Joe at WrestleMania 2 whenever that happens. It's supposed to happen. And
yeah, we gotta ramp back up to that, I guess.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Vinny.
Yeah, but neither of these two likes each other. Lick Joe doesn't like Ned. Ned doesn't like anybody.
I have a problem. I think Ned's tie is stapled to his throat.
I can't tell from this angle.
It doesn't look like it's part of his shirt. It's stapled to his body. Look!
It is. It's stapled to his
Jesus
body.
Christ,
what
this
the
guy's
fuck?
Like, he's like a fucking villain from Seven.
Speaking of murdering villains, here comes Lick Joe.
How is he still the champion after going to prison?
Do you think anybody actually was able to take the belt from him in there?
He wore it into the jail, so I doubt it.
Yeah, and he wore it back out.
Or how many people he killed in there? I mean, what should we take the tally up to?
Well, he didn't kill him in the ring, so it doesn't count.
Oh, that's a good point. Who knows how many guys he's actually killed? We only count the ones he's killed in the ring.
We're only counting the ones we know about, but we
what
can
is
verify.
What is he up to? 16? 15? 16?
I don't remember. It's like 15, 14, something like that.
It's just disturbing, regardless.
Yeah, it's just way out of control. Completely out of control.
What the fuck is this now? What? Who the fuck hired a young Ross Perot?
Well, apparently
okay,
the guys in charge did.
I'm fucking confused here. He either looks like young Ross Perot, Mini-Me, or my ass.
I haven't seen your ass, so I...
Well, it looks a lot like him.
Does your ass have a dollar sign tattooed on it?
Not the last time I checked.
In any case, fans, Dollar Bill on his way to the ring.
Look at the
claims to be the richest guy? The richest man in professional wrestling.
Is that the Fat Boys? How old is this motherfucker? He couldn't even have been alive when these guys were rapping.
Maybe he heard it on the radio.
Maybe he's an asshole.
I think that's not a maybe.
Why is he balder than a fucking unshaven prick?
You know, his head kind of does look like a penis, as you mentioned it.
His
face
looks
too small for his head. You notice that?
Yeah, he looks like his face is like...
No, you know what he looks like? He looks like the old Bugs Bunny witch.
He also kind of looks like Reducto.
He does, yeah.
If Reducto wasn't like... What color is Reducto? Green? I don't even remember.
Yeah, he's green. Well, you know, it's 1960s Hanna-Barbera animation, so sometimes he was green, sometimes he was blue.
Who the fuck knows? I hope this fat trucker just rips him a new asshole. I hope he has Quan Chi's fatality on him.
Well,
rips his
seen,
leg off and beats him.
I haven't seen Dollar Bill in action at all, so I don't know what he's capable of, but I know the other guys in this ring are all capable of stomping his ass. So, especially this guy. Trucker Fred was definitely torn up by the loss of Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper. Rest in peace, Hot Rod. I'm going to keep wearing the shirt in honor of him.
Yeah, I kicked him in the nuts once.
You kicked him in the nuts, Hot Rod?
Yes. It was that
I hope it was in a match.
No, it was at a press event. I bet
things
you don't think I'm
on national television.
I bet you don't think I'm a very nice guy.
I know you're not a nice guy.
Yeah, I get paid for it, too.
Trucker Fred, rounding out our six-man battle royal here tonight, folks. Who's your money on here, Mr. Wiggles? Well, I mean, I know you can't actually reveal who your actual money is on, but theoretically, you know, if you weren't actually betting on this, if you had to place a bet right now, who would your
money be? Yeah, my bookies have advised me not to talk about who I'm betting on, but... I don't know. Ned?
All right, Mr. Wiggles says Ned. Me?
I say Ned or Lick Joe because I look at the rest of them.
Well, Trucker Fred's got the size, but he hasn't really proven anything here at WTF yet.
He hasn't had very many matches.
No,
I think the
hasn't.
Only other one that's competent that I know of is Matt, Cowboy Matt.
Yeah, Cowboy Matt. Dollar Bill getting the shit stomped out of him.
Yeah, there he goes, doing the fucking Pennsylvania stomp on his ass.
Yep, that's... Well, he calls the finisher the Pennsylvania Polka. Maybe that's the Pennsylvania two-step. Oh,
I have no idea.
Yeah, Pennsylvania five knuckles to the nuts.
Yeah, Pennsylvania right in the two. If he has to. This guy could be a one-nut wonder. We don't know.
Yeah, that's true. Could be a no-nut wonder for all I know.
That makes me wonder if Mr. Hilter had one nut. You know, just to be historically accurate.
I can't
know
even...
now. He's fucking dead.
Anyway, fans, be that as it may, Lard Ass with a big belly-to-belly suplex on Lick Joe.
A big belly. A big belly to anything.
And this Cowboy Mac getting chucked across the ring like a bag of potatoes.
Don't say potatoes. Lard Ass will get hungry.
He's always hungry.
Yeah, but he, like I said, it's just going to enrage the Lard Ass, the inner Lard Ass. He's going to start just fucking hungry-mongering everybody in the ring.
And there's the Shel Silverstein reference for you, folks. We bring it all here.
I was going to say Pac-Man, but I figured I'd say that later.
Did you say something about Pac-Man?
I was originally going to say Pac-Man, but I'll save that one for later.
Yeah.
What the hell are these asshole fucking chanting for?
Someone named Superstar, apparently.
Superstar Billy Graham's already out of here.
Well,
he's on earlier.
This Superstar guy was on the top of the marquee. We just put him there to get people in, and they think he's here, and they keep chanting for him to come out, but
yeah, we never even employed a guy named
so.
Superstar.
Hmm?
Yeah, we never even employed a guy named Superstar.
No, we haven't. I think they think it's going to be Steve Austin. Because he was Superstar Steve Austin at one point.
Well, yeah, they probably think it's going to be Steve Austin because we put him on our fucking programs.
Well, Lick Joe... Just missed a senton in the corner on Ned Ryerson. It looks like Ned's going for the Pennsylvania Polka. Yeah.
He's proving that he's the real champ.
And down with the champ. Valdez gets to go for the cover now. He can eliminate the champ. One.
Here comes that fat fuck. Look out.
No. Lick Joe kicking out. Do you think that that was a kick out because something's wrong with Ryerson? Or do you think maybe he was distracted? Or
I think it's the first real hit Lick Joe's taken until right then when a fucking trucker falls on him.
Yeah. Here's Dollar Bill getting. Oh, man.
Oh, man. That fat bastard fell on him.
That's it for Bill. I mean, look at that skinny prick. There's no way he's surviving that. Two. Three, yeah, Larness.
At least he's got the money for his doctor bills. Get the fuck out of here, Ross Perot.
There's Lick Joe with the DDT that killed Mr. Hilter.
Looks like an uncircumcised cock.
Two, three. Trucker well, Fred is out for the DDT.
It didn't kill Trucker Fred, at least. That fucking Tommy Madden's powerbombed the shit out of the former champion.
I can't believe his hat stayed on after that. There's a TDT for
Jesus Christ. Well, he staples a fucking tie to his throat or some shit. What's he going to do with the hat? Probably nailed on.
Yeah, for all I know, it could be.
Motherfucker's a Cenobite.
So we're down to Lardass and Matt and Lick Joe and Ned Ryerson.
Lardass in this ring.
I don't know. It looks like he thinks Lick Joe's a corn dog or something.
Well, he is orange. He probably thinks he's like, space tang or something.
A Shasta?
Something he can just grab a squeeze into his mouth.
Well, he just dropped him, gave him a snake eyes on the top turnbuckle.
Think he's a tube of peach go-gurt.
There's the go-gurt reference for you, folks.
Fucking lard ass.
Uh-oh.
What is he gonna do?
Lick Joe to the corner.
Oh, jeez, don't do this. This is a fate worse than death.
Oh, no. Gonna sit up. Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Big fat sweaty balls in your face. Three.
Oh my God, you just pinned the champion.
Lardass just pinned the champion. And Cowboy Matt's got Ned down. Three. Cowboy Matt pinned Ned Ryerson.
Holy shit.
What the fuck?
What the hell's going on here?
Now, what the fuck?
A lot has changed in.
Holy shit.
Christ.
Cowboy Matt power bombs this fat Lardass.
He's forcing his head down on the mat.
And he gets the three. Holy shit. Cowboy Matt making a statement here. He pins Ned Ryerson and Lardass.
After he powerbombed both of them.
Yeah. That powerbomb's turning into a hell of a weapon for Cowboy Matt.
Well, that's changed over the last few months.
Yeah.
Cowboy Matt's getting really pissed. Look, there's Dick Rictus leaving back there.
Yeah, he wants his briefcase back, I guess. Here he is DDTing Ned. I think Ned Ryerson and Lick Joe did not expect this.
Here comes the worst thing that ever happened to mankind.
Oh, God. Just fat, sweaty balls. God, I can't even.
Hey, I don't think he's ever taken off those sweatpants. You know they got to smell like fucking balls.
Oh, Jesus. I didn't even think about that. I hope he just fucking 17-year-old dies.
17-year-old sweaty balls and fucking swamp ass.
Oh, I'm going to be sick. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Cowboy Matt wins our Battle Royal here tonight. Planted Lardass like a tulip. He's hoping to do that at WrestleMania 2 and get his briefcase back.
That fat fuck pushing up the daisies, hopefully. Got a Japanese guy with a hot rod shirt on out there. The hell's up with that?
Oh, well, apparently this isn't over yet.
I told you.
I told you Dave would be pissed that he didn't get any action tonight.
What I'm curious about is who picked this fight, because Danger Dan and fucking Liz Manless are fucking stupid enough to do it.
I don't think it actually stopped.
It might not have.
I don't think the fight stopped. I mean, it stopped for long enough.
Oh,
for them
shit.
To...
What's he going
to
do?
Danger Dan's fighting for his life.
Well, what life?
Well, what little he has.
I hope he takes that phone off and beats him like Don Rickles. A casino.
First into the door.
Knock, knock, motherfucker.
What the fuck?
What the shit? The door just came open. Oh!
What the hell? Ooh!
Oh! My Holy God! Shit!
It's the debut of our new Korean superstar, Sukmi Wong. Sukmi Wong, everybody. This guy's supposed to be really good. I don't know why it hasn't been picked up before now. But he's supposed to. He has a good resume.
Maybe that's why. His name isn't Sukmi Wong. It's Suck My Way.
That's not how it's pronounced.
I don't give a shit how it's pronounced. That's how it's spelled, and that's what it is. So we're gonna be announcing Suck My Wang everywhere we go.
I'm not. I'm announcing Sukmi Wong. That's his name.
Well, I don't give... His name is Suck My Wang. And that's what he can do.
He already down on the guy. Haven't you seen him wrestle yet?
Because he's got a stupid fucking name. Whoever named him that should be fucking ashamed of themselves.
Yeah, who here doesn't have a stupid fucking name?
I'm thinking.
Anyway, fans, Suk Mi Wong out here for his debut match. We have actually a trio of debuts tonight. Suk Mi Wong's going to be the third guy. He's facing someone that you're all familiar with.
Oh, whoever it is, break him in half.
There is a distinct possibility of someone being broken in half here.
Yeah, there he is, the same fucking outfit he's always owned.
Yes, he's had those singlets since he was 4 years old, as far as I know.
According to his stories.
You can never tell what's the truth and what isn't with Man Mountain McGurk.
Where's his manager tonight?
His manager could not be here. He's at a symposium. That's what I was told.
A symposium.
Oh, you judge whether or not that's the truth. For James Bane's mouth, it could be bullshit. Most likely is.
Symposium.
So symposium. He said that he was not only was he attending it, he was speaking at it.
Symposium for what? That's why.
It wasn't specific. I just said he's not here tonight because.
You know, I think our cameramen are gay or something. They were just getting a close-up shot of Man Mountain McGurk's crotch.
Well, yeah, the referee, or not the referee, but the ring announcer I know is.
Yeah, that guy was definitely checking out somebody's ass. I don't remember
who it was. I see him checking out lots of asses. Fans, you may be wondering, I know everybody loves the Man Mountain McGurk stories, and I know everybody wants me to track Mr. McGurk down and get a story, but this week, I didn't have to track him down. He actually came to me with a story. So here's Man Mountain McGurk with story time. Take a listen.
Let me tell you a story. I wrestled Suk Mi Wong's dad, Leek Mi Wong, in Puerto Rico in 1997. He was a very nice guy, but he couldn't wrestle for shit. I had to demonstrate how to do a flying head scissors to him in the locker room. We had a decent match regardless. Everything was fine until after the match. Those Puerto Ricans didn't know much more English than he did, but they knew what it meant when they looked at their programs and saw someone was writing Lick My Wang on it. They were pissed. It's a good thing I'm a national hero down there because they strung him up. We're going to beat him to death till I saved him. That's why I hate piñatas.
See? I told you. And the son of a bitch, his name was Lick My Wang. Named his son Suck My Wang.
I don't want to know much about this. Whoa! That was a big, impressive belly-to-belly suplex on Man Mountain McGurk there.
Jesus. That was a chin buster. That's highly technical.
I would say, well, maybe not technical, but certainly effective.
The jury's still out on that.
Yeah, I see he's taking McGurk by surprise a little bit here. Or maybe McGurk's just got fond memories of his dad.
Maybe he's got respect for the son.
Yeah.
Shit. You expect anybody with a name like that.
Oh! Big chop.
Uh-oh.
Now we're kicking him right in the ass. Oh, my God.
Kicked him in the ass so hard that he went bouncing out of the corner, even.
Well, McGurk is a powerful man.
What are those people putting their flags on their asses? This his is a little higher than the fucking asshole.
It's like tradition, you know? Goes on the back of the tights. I don't know. Oh! Somebody taught McGurk a knee drop. That had to be Bane. One, two, no. Kick out.
Jesus. Man should never be leaving his feet like that.
A man his size? No. It's like that running senton that Trucker Fred does.
Oh!
Suk Mi Wong trying to get a somewhat respectable performance here. I don't know that he's going to win, but...
Well, you never know.
Well, that was
just
not...
ran up and decked Man Mountain McGurk.
Yeah, but it didn't seem to hurt him very much. Suk Mi Wong showing off some power.
He's just some leverage, too.
He's going for an armbar, it looks like. Well, he didn't hold on to it very long. That's a mistake. And trying to match guts with Man Mountain McGurk is another mistake.
He was trying to outweight him.
Oh, McGurk just runs over him. Going for a cover again. I think he's trying to tell the kid, get out of the ring, don't make me hurt you. But I guess that's going to work. And ooh!
Oh no!
Well, that's it for Soup Me Wong, folks.
He just got fucking mashed.
Three. He just got mashed like a fucking potato.
Yeah, he can suck my way.
You're just gonna have a ball with that one, aren't you?
How can you not? It's his name! I don't give a shit what the little nuances and the little faggy things above the letters are.
I guess the Soup Me Wong kicking out there was a highlight of the match. I mean, it's unusual for a
rookie. Oh, no! He got mashed in the Korean paste.
Yeah, but he wasn't getting up after that.
What's that shit they use? Fish sauce or whatever? I don't know.
I really don't know much about Korean cuisine, Mr. Wiggles. In any case, Mad Mountain McGurk successful here tonight.
And quite an interesting story.
Yeah, quite an interesting story. And now he's yelling at the crowd.
God, look at the guy's mouth. Jesus, it's horrifying.
Everything about Mad Mountain McGurk is
look
horrifying.
About, yeah, he looks like a Final Fantasy monster.
Yeah, boss.
Look at that fucking mouth, looks like an Esper.
A Gurk Esper.
That's somebody.
And we're still going, folks!
Oh, geez, look at Dan! Oh! I hope one of them dies.
Dan's holding his ass, oh god!
Well, his ass, because he's probably getting fucked in it. Somebody get that car and run Dan over with it. He'll live, I've done it.
You've done it?
Yes, I've done it. Run him over a couple of times.
I'm not even going to ask for the details of that story, but... Well, at least Looks Manless actually got a hit in there. That's something, I guess, right?
It's not much of an achievement. Oh, my, he just slapped him like a woman. His partners get thrown up against a bunch of... What do we have oil drums out there for?
I don't know. Why do we have oil drums?
What do we have oil drums in the arena for? Oh, he just barely missed that bumper. I'm a little sad about that. Wish his head hit it, it would have been a clonk.
Belly suplex.
Oh,
back
God.
Into the oil drums for Dan.
Back into the oil drums that are mysteriously there.
Ooh.
Oh, God, he's going to kill
him. There's a T-bone.
Hey,
oh, the master gets him dead. Holy shit. Why'd you cut away from that?
I think I know why those oil drums are there. Bo and Dave brought them to the arena. They're going to put these two assholes in them and put them in the river.
That's certainly possible. They keep moving to different areas of the arena.
I hope they put him in there at least. That's what I would do with
him. Here comes King Slender for our main event. During the break, he got a little snippy with Giant Panther about who's going to use this particular theme song. And challenged Panther to a match to see who gets to keep the music. Now, Panther said he didn't give a fuck about the music, but he wasn't going to turn down the challenge.
Sounds like Panther.
Yeah, so...
I think King Slender just bit a huge chunk off a sandwich he can't swallow.
Yeah, I'm inclined to agree with you. The guy that shattered American Gladiator's helmet and... If I'm remembering correctly, didn't
he
beat
Mongo
Marv?
Down. And I thought he put Mongo down, at least got him close to being down.
Yeah.
And the... I don't know what the hell that's called now.
It was the number one contenders tournament. Here he comes, the man himself, folks. Looks unimpressed as usual.
Yeah, he just looks like life is a bird. He would like to snuff it all out. Not his life, everybody else's.
Do you think he's referring to the shoe company when he says Puma hanging low?
No, I think he's probably referring to the great Puma. But it could be the shoe company, I don't know. Maybe he's got somebody against Puma shoes. You want to ask him?
No.
Because you're probably just going to get headbutted.
Yeah, I don't want to
get headbutted. If he headbutts one of us, I mean, that's game over.
Yeah, it is. It's game over. No continues on that one.
No.
No extra lives.
I mean, seriously, you're going to come out looking like Clint Howard. That guy should have continued long ago.
He should have just thrown the rest of his lives away and started over, right?
Yeah, seriously. He should have re-rolled.
In any case, folks, Giant Panther versus King Slender in our main event tonight for the rights to use that pro wrestling remix as their entrance music. Panther said he doesn't care about it. He just wants to beat Slender's ass.
Slender immediately going to the back rake. You gotta expect him for that.
And working the ribs, going to the torso right away, setting up that backbreaker. Panther a little bit more of a technical counter than you would have expected out of a big man.
Well, he doesn't know. Yeah, but... say, ow, another back rake. It's not like he doesn't know how to wrestle. He just doesn't need to.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, the ring, fucking
mess. Yeah, he's the wrestle when you can do that.
Yeah, you just throw a guy with such velocity at the turnbuckle that he just fucking flies into it.
Yeah, he just bounces off the corner and
just
beat him with these hands on the ends of your wrists.
Beat him in the face like he's, like, I don't know how the hell you describe that.
Chops, punches, there's another big shot to the forehead. Panther paying Slender back now for those back rakes. Back rake isn't even a damaging move. It's just annoying and disrespectful, and I don't think that's something you want to be to Giant Panther.
It can't hurt if you use nails.
You're talking about, like, construction nails, right?
No, I'm talking about fingernails.
Oh. Slender with a belly-to-belly suplex trying to reverse the momentum here.
I'm talking about the wrestler nails.
What about the wrestler nails?
Oh, when he does a back rake, he usually does it with some barbed wire.
How the fuck did nails even get brought up? There's another back rake.
Another back rake, courtesy of nails.
I completely forgot what we were even watching now. I'm thinking about fucking nails and the steroid trial. Thanks a lot.
You know that nails attacked Vince McMahon once?
Yeah, I heard that. Can we not talk about nails?
but he's an interesting man.
How? He drools everywhere. What's
interesting
about that?
Him and Kurgan the Interrogator, they're like interesting because they're like human specimens of like the Missing Link.
I was gonna say they're interesting because they didn't evolve past Cro-Magnon.
Yes, that's interesting. How did they do that? We should
There's
be
another back
rake. More.
Will you please stop back raking him?
Yeah, you're gonna piss nails off.
Fuck nails. Giant Panther with a looks like a swing out of a pancake move. Not an arm drag and twist. Elbow drops to the ribs.
Oh my god!
It.
He just fucking broke his fucking rice bowl.
Yeah, oh. Moves, Mr. Wiggles. I can hear you slurping that can.
You did not hear anything. That's totally not what you heard.
King Slender choking now, showing off all of his technical skill. Back rakes, chokes. Another back rake.
Taking a page out of a colleague of mine's book.
Yeah, two missed kicks. That was funky looking. Left-handed lariat from Slender. I wouldn't have expected that.
Oh!
There was a full arm drag and twist, if you ask Scott Hudson.
There's a full arm drag and twist. Somebody needs to fucking full on twist his ass off. Fuck it, Scott.
Please
Hudson.
Don't. Okay, good lord. Thank you for the backdrop. Back suplex there by King Slender. Not a back rake for once.
Yeah.
Or choking. Nails. Has he done? I mean, that's like he's done like two wrestling moves in this whole match.
Yeah, majorly the two things that Nails did: choking and back rakes.
I was talking about the. Never mind. Slender face first into the canvas. And now Panther face first into the canvas. I wouldn't have expected that.
Well, he's got to use a little brute force if he wants to win this match, because
yeah,
his little finesse
right.
Shit isn't going to work.
Yeah.
That's not working very much at all. I think he's just pissed Panther off on the fucking back race.
Oof, yeah. Yeah, he's trying to break his hand. I'll teach you to back rake me, you son of a bitch. Slender out on one.
Yeah, not enough people stomp the hand.
Yeah, I agree, honestly. It's a big chop from Slender.
Back right into the ref. The ref was like, oh, God, I guess I should move. Stupid
yeah,
zebra.
There's a hammerlock from now. The most technical submission move done so far in this match was done by Giant Panther, and it was a hammerlock, so...
It's more of a setup move than anything else.
Yeah. This match is straight out of 1984.
The book or the year?
The year!
Okay, just making sure.
How can it be out of the book? There hasn't been a 2 minutes hate.
I don't know. You should ask King Slender that. While you're at it, get the number for nails.
Here's Giant Panther with a press slam. There we go. Slender crashing hard into the mat. I was getting punched in the ear.
Yeah, punched in the ear. The fucking Fight Club punches.
Yeah, Fight Club punched. Slender looks like he's out on his feet. There's another press slam coming up. I think Panther's getting ready to finish this one off.
He needs to put the claw on him. No, he's just content beating the fucking piss out of him.
Maybe he's teaching him a lesson now.
Oof. Ooh.
Big elbow drop right to the sternum. Oh, there's Slender with a desperation knee.
Yeah, but it had some oomph on it, though.
Yes, it did. Chops and punches. Panther blocks the chop.
Then again, I think you could probably hit Panther with a fucking tire tool and he wouldn't feel it.
Those elbows to the back of the head, though. That'll disorient you in a hurry.
Yeah, but that's doing him no fucking good.
I agree.
Man, I know he's trying to set up the figure four and all, but...
Well, he doesn't use the figure four. He uses the backbreaker as his finisher.
Oh, you could have fooled me.
Here's Panther. What do we got here? It's like a big, maybe a brain buster? No. Big vertical suplex.
I'll say, is it a delayed suplex? Or?
Yeah. Panther going for the cover. One. No, King Slender out on one.
One and a half. How is he getting up?
What's Panther heading? What is he doing now?
Oh, jeez. What's he going to do?
Panther throwing King Slender out to the apron.
What's this going to be now?
He's going out with him. I don't know.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Slender DDT on the apron.
Panther's just looking at him like he's a dead man.
Yeah, he's admiring his handiwork.
He's admiring his kill like a tiger.
Or Panther, one might say. Uh-oh. No, Slender, he can't execute the backbreaker. Panther reverses it.
Probably not. His fucking head's dented in.
Now, Panther going for the camel clutch. He doesn't just want to win. He wants to make him squeal.
Let's make him humble.
Yeah, and he's got it. Giant Panther's DDT King Slender in the apron and making him humble.
He didn't even use the claw or the headbutt.
No, that's scary.
Why is this man, like, not the champion?
Because he hasn't had a match with, like, Joe yet? That's the only reason. That big vertical suplex. See if we can say a DDT again. No, well, here's Slender desperation going for the backbreaker, but Panther was well scouted that. And here is King Slender being humble.
Looks like fucking King Slender's gonna have to find himself some new fucking music.
Yeah, well, Panther said he didn't give a fuck about the music, so I don't really know what's gonna be resolved by all of this.
Well, I know the one thing that's gonna be resolved is King Slender needs to pull Panther's boot out of his ass.
That's absolutely true. Folks, this was our main event tonight. It was good to bring WTF back to you once again. Hopefully we'll see you all next week from, somewhere. What the hell?
How'd they end up at Walmart?
I don't know.